हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी द टॉपिक क्रॉस कल्चर डायनेमिक्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द वीडियो लेक्चर. फर्स्ट देयर इज अ दैट द ट्रेंड्स ऑफ ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज प्रोवाइडिंग द अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इंडियन फर्म्स टू रीच टू द फॉरेन मार्केट. मीन्स बेसिकली द ग्लोबलाइजेशन विल हेल्प द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू एक्सपेंड देयर बिजनेसेस. सो एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कंसिस्ट ऑफ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल्स विच बिलोंग्स टू द सेवरल कल्चर्स. सो द कल्चर कैन बी डिफाइंड एज अ शेयर सिस्टम ऑफ वैल्यू बिलीव्स एंड एटीट्यूड्स. शेयर सिस्टम ऑफ वैल्यू बिलीव्स एंड एटीट्यूड्स. सो एजम्पशन एंड बिलीव्स फाइंड मैनिफेस्टेशन इन वेरियस फॉर्म्स लाइक फिजिकल आर्टिफैक्ट्स, इंस्टीट्यूशन, सोशल सिस्टम एंड ऑल्सो इन द बिहेवियर ऑफ मेम्बर्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी. सो वी ऑल बिलोंग्स टू द एंटायर कलेक्शन ऑफ कल्चर. सो विच इंक्लूड द नेशनल कल्चर, सब कल्चर बेस्ड ऑन रीजन एंड ट्राइब्स, एंड ऑल्सो ऑर्गनाइजेशनल और कॉरपोरेट कल्चर, इंडस्ट्री कल्चर, प्रोफेशनल और अ फंक्शनल कल्चर. सो दिस इंक्रीजेज द नीड ऑफ द प्रोफेशनल्स हु विल वर्क इन अ फॉरेन कल्चर सेटिंग. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज कल्चर. सो वॉट इज कल्चर? सो कल्चर इज वेरी पावरफुल फोर्स इन द वर्क प्लेस विच इज कॉन्शियसली और डेलिबरेटेड कल्टिवेटेड एंड इट इज पास टू द इनकमिंग एम्प्लॉयज. सो इट जनरली रिफ्लेक्ट्स द ट्रू नेचर एंड पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ एन ऑर्गनाइजेशन. इन दिस वे वी कैन से दैट इट एक्चुअली रिफ्लेक्ट्स द डीएनए रिफ्लेक्ट द डीएनए ऑफ एन ऑर्गनाइजेशन. सो कल्चर कंसिस्ट ऑफ पैटर्न्स, एक्सप्लिसिट एंड इम्प्लिसिट बिहेवियर एक्वायर्ड और ट्रांसमिटेड बाय सिम्बॉल्स. सो इट कैन बी डिफाइंड इन इंडियन परस्पेक्टिव एज अ कल्चर कंसिस्ट ऑफ टोटैलिटी ऑफ एजम्पशन, बिलीव्स, वैल्यू एंड सोशल सिस्टम, इंस्टीट्यूशन, फिजिकल आर्टिफैक्ट्स एंड बिहेवियर ऑफ द पीपल, रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ देयर डिजायर टू मेंटेन कंटिन्यूटी एज वेल एज टू अडॉप्ट टू द एक्सटर्नल डिमांड. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंडियन. सो देयर इज अ लिंकेज अमंग द वेरियस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द कल्चर दैट बाइंड द कल्चर टुगेदर एंड मेक एनी चेंजेस इन वन पार्ट ऑफ द कंपोनेंट डिफिकल्ट विदाउट कॉजिंग चेन रिएक्शन. सो ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल कल्चर इज अ आउटकम ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल फंक्शंस ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट इज़ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स सोशल सिस्टम. सो नेक्स्ट वी विल स्टडी द क्रॉस कल्चर. सो वॉट इज क्रॉस कल्चर? सो द क्रॉस कल्चर इन द बिजनेस वर्ल्ड रिफर्स टू द कंपनीज एफर्ट्स टू इंश्योर दैट इट्स पीपल इंटरेक्ट इफेक्टिवली विद प्रोफेशनल्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड फ्रॉम देयर ओन. सो द एडजेक्टिव क्रॉस कल्चर इम्प्लाइज दैट रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ नेशनल, रीजनल एंड एथिकल डिफरेंसेस इन अ मैनर एंड अ मेथड एंड अ डिजायर टू ब्रिज देम. Means basically just to identify the cultures of different nation and region and also the different ethnic groups in the world. So the field of study cross culture dynamic has emerged to define and understand the many ways the different people of the world communicate with each other verbally or non-verbally. Now next we will study that how the cross culture work. Thus the concept of cross culture is becoming critically important in the era of globalization. So many countries that seeks to expand their market for their product devote the substantial resources to training the employees, that is how to communicate and interact effectively with those from the other cultures. So the cross culture is a concept that recognizes the differences amongst the business people of different nations, backgrounds and ethnicities and importance of bridging them. Means there is a common path so that people can walk through the different cultures. So with globalization, the cross-culture education has become critically important to businesses. So the business people working abroad needs to learn the subtle differences in styles and substances in order to be effective. For example, when an employee of an international company transfer to the another country, so they need to master the cross culture. So they must not only learn the language but also adopt the social norms of that country. Now next we will study the cross culture dynamics. The meaning of cross culture dynamics. So it means that when any organization have more or one cultured people and are working together, so there is a clash or there is a conflict due to this. So in order to solve this clash, so this type of the firm is required to develop a system and a processes for the managers to handle so that he can handle the culture diversities. So the impact of cross culture. The cross culture leads to the cultural shock, which is a mental state of stress. Just the individual might feel lonely due to the sudden change in working environment. The process of encountering and accepting the change includes the four stages. So these are the four stages. So the first one is known as honeymoon stage or tourist stage or tourist phase. So also honeymoon phase is also referred to as a tourist stage in the culture shock cycle. Some of the persons enter in this phase while they are still in a planning mode. So this stage of cycle is met when heightened enthusiasm, excitement, and also there is a possible fear of unknown and overwhelming sense of adventure and mission. So during this stage, the person leaves off to the thrill of being a new place and only see the positive aspect of their adopted country. So next is the culture shock. So alienation sets in during this stage when the people start to miss the familiarities of their home country. Some of the people become isolated, quick to anger and impatient, while the physical ailments such as the tiredness and depression will surround them. So persons in this stage tends to focus on the differences between their home country and also between their new country and become increasingly critical for their new surroundings. So next is the humor phase. So during this stage, the language and skill improves and a person begins to understand how their new environment work, and they are on the road to recovery. Now next is the mastery phase or at home stage. So the person who can accept Now the last stage is a mastery stage or at home stage. So the person who can accept and embrace their new culture have arrived in the final stage of culture shock cycle, and people in this phase begins to enjoy at least some aspect of their new lives and feel a sense of balance and contentment. Next we will study the people's relationship with their environment. So in many developed countries, will people try to dominate the environment by using the sophisticated equipments. So on the other hand, often the people often accept the environment as it is and adjust their own living condition. So under this, the first relationship with their environment is first factor is time dimension. So the people differ from each other in their orientation to time. So in some countries, people tend to be oriented towards the past, while some of the countries they will focus on the present. So there is also some countries where the people will generally have the futuristic outlook. For example, North Americans believe in preserving the history and continuing with the tradition. So whereas Japan and China are future oriented. Now next factor is a public and private space. So in few countries, people give a lot of importance to their private and public space. Example, the top executive and heads of American organizations are not easily accessible to the lower level employees to the public place. So in countries like Japan, the private space is not given much importance. Now next we will study the barriers to culture adaptation. So under this, the first one is parochialism. So parochialism means generally focus on narrow things and avoid the wide things. So it refers to the tendency of the person to take the narrow or restricted view on the matter. So the next is culture distance. So it is important since it affects the behavior and responses of various persons involved in the organization and in its business arrangement. Next is culture shock. So the persons generally faces many difficulties when they try to adopt to the culture and customs of the host country. So when they arrive to the foreign country, they typically go through the series of phases in their attempt to adjust to the new culture. So these are the three barriers which are generally faced by the peoples when they start working in the foreign country. So thank you very much for listening it very patiently.